Keep taking out overseers. We'll warm up to you just fine.
Good work.
Oh, shit.
Byrne was a
tough
prick. Goodbye,
Vice Overseer. Paula wins then.
Look who's the big hero.
Someone said you took out Byrne. If so, take his corpse to Paolo.
they just walk along the water.
Not in the mood. Show yourself.
I knew I was right about you. Mindy ain't no fool. I can smell a winner.
They say hard days make strange friends.
If we had more time, I'd put my tattoo and needles on your ass. Leave you with some wicked ink.
What's one more black mark? But I'm short on time.
Next time, maybe. You help me with the overseers. We could use somebody like you.
Hand. Time to pay off your debt to society, Paolo.
For Paolo, I bet.
Goodbye, Vysos. Paolo wins.
sense in him. The youngest man to reach Vice Overseer in decades. Lena Byrne. He has moved up quickly in the Abbey's hierarchy. He might be High Overseer someday. He barely tolerates this new Duke. They must interact on occasion, but he does not like it. He grew up in the cold mists of Freyport, on the northernmost tip of Morley. He was nothing then. Now, the Overseers look to him for answers and leadership. When he is a boy, and an Overseer stepped out of the mist, Wolfhound by his side. Voice was deep and strong as he recited the invocations. Young Liam Byrne was transfixed. His faith is strong, perhaps overly so. He sees the influence of the Outsider everywhere. In the Duke, the Streets, and even the Miners. Something nags at him, beyond the usual worries. He will consult the Sisters of the Oracular Order, and they will set his feet on the right path. His father taught him to read, using letters carved into handcrafted wooden blocks. He seeks to weed out the witches and heretics, those who have succumbed to the lure of the void, and who bring chaos where they tread. And as a boy, turned in by his mother for his restless hands, he extracted a confession as he would from anyone else. It would have jeopardized his ascent to Vice Overseer to do otherwise. His mother encouraged his musical talent, but his interests lay in the comfort of the strictures and the rigors of the Abbey. He has seen a troubling increase in superstitious beliefs and the use of charms and spells. He waits for guidance from the Oracular Order. Once a week, he meets an old friend of his mother's for dinner at a cafe at the edge of town. He listens to her stories again and again with great patience. When his years in Karnaca come to an end, he hopes to move to the capital. In Dunwall, he will have the ear of the High Overseer himself. Before they took him away for the trials of aptitude, the Overseers in Freyport watched him for months, debating his promise. If he has any other secrets, they are hidden from me.
I hope 5 years away gives you time to think while the city rebuilds itself without your little war.